You can use a scanner object in your Java program to ask for user input. But first, you need to import the class by typing import java.util.scanner. And then you can go ahead and create a scanner object. I'll type scanner input. This creates a scanner variable called input. And then I'll say equals new scanner. And inside parentheses, I'll type system.in. This creates a new scanner object that will read input from the keyboard. To read a line of input, we use the nextLine method of the scanner class. This method will return the line as a string, so we can assign it to a string variable. So we can say string s1 is equal to input.nextLine. Let's go ahead and ask for another line of input. String s2 is equal to input.nextLine. So if we run the program, it will pause when it reaches this part where we ask for the first line of input. The user will have to type a line in the console and then press enter. After that, it will pause again because we are asking for input again here. So the user will once again have to type a line and press enter before the program continues. Then, just to check if we were able to store the input, let's go ahead and print them out. Let's say system.out.println s1 plus an empty space plus s2. So let me just save this first. So now let's run this in the command line. Let's compile this first. Java C console input.java and then Java console input. So now the program is waiting for me to type something. I'll say hello world and then I'll hit enter. So that's for the first input. And now the program is expecting me to input another one. I'll just say, how are you? And then I'll hit enter. And here we see the correct output, which means our program is working correctly. Now, if you want to provide some kind of prompt for the user to tell them what to input, then you can just use println before you ask for input. So for example, before this first call to nextLine, we can say, system.out.println, please input a greeting. And then before the second one, we can say system.out.println, please input a name. So let's compile that again. And then let's go ahead and run the program. So there is the first prompt. Please input a greeting. So I'll just say hello and hit enter. And then there's a second prompt. Please input a name. I'll just say John and hit enter. And there's our output. Hello, John. Now, if we wanted to treat our input as integers so that we can perform arithmetic operations on them, we are going to have to parse the input. Right now, they are being treated as strings, so we'll have to go ahead and parse them. I'll go ahead and change the string variables to integer variables instead. I'll make this int n1, and then I'll make this other one int n2. And then to parse the line of input into an integer, we type integer.parseInt. and then we pass to it the call to next line. Now I'll just go ahead and change the prompts here. Please input a number. Please input another number. And then I'll change the print statement expression here to say just n1 plus n2 instead. So let me just save this. And then in the command line, let me compile it again. And then I'll run the program. So for the first number, I'll input 5. And then I will input 2. And we see the correct output, which is 7.